Hello student, in this video we are going to talk about introduction on pathology. In this video we are going to see what do you understand by pathology, what are the terms, important terms in relationship with pathology, what are the different subdivisions are there in pathology. So basically, pathology is broadly classified into two categories. One is human pathology, another one is plant pathology. So we're going to deal with human pathology out here. So as per the definition is concerned, pathology, the word pathos, it is derived from a Greek word which means suffering, and logos means study. So pathology is a scientific study of structure and function of a body in a disease state, or I would say in other words, pathology consists of all the abnormalities which occur in a normal anatomy and physiology due to disease state. So So any form of study, whether it is anatomically based or what study, or physiologically based of study in a human body in a disease state, then that terms is called as pathology. So Rudolf Virchow is one of the German physicists and anthropologist, and he has done a very great work in the area of cell. So because of which he is also called as father of modern pathology. And there are different terms which are important in case of pathology when you study human pathology. The first one is patient. So what do you understand by patient? Patient are nothing but patient are the person who has been affected by the disease. And the next term is called as lesions. Lesions are nothing but it is a characteristic changes in the tissue or a cell in an individual or an experimental animal which has been produced by the disease. So the next is pathological changes, or any form of changes which has been visualized by the naked eye, or any microscopic changes because occurs due to a disease state. And to observe these pathological changes, I have told you before, it has divided into two types. One is gross examination, other one is microscopic examination. So gross examinations, also called as macroscopic examinations, are the examinations which can we do with the naked eye, and microscopic examinations are the kind of examinations for which we use microscope to observe minute details of an cells or a tissue. The next terms which are very much important in an area of pathology is casual factors, or I also call as etiological factors. So etiological factors are nothing but it's a causative factors of a lesion, which is also called as why of the disease. The next term is called as pathogenesis. Pathogenesis is nothing but how of the disease, that means mechanism of which the lesions are produced. So that is termed as pathogenesis. Physical signs and symptoms are nothing but if we talk about symptoms. Symptoms are nothing but the functional implications or the functional abnormalities of a lesion which has been felt by the patient. That is called as symptoms. And as per the sign is concerned, the signs are nothing but which has been discovered by the clinicians. So it is very much important for you to know the difference between sign and symptoms. Symptoms are nothing but the which has been felt by the patients, like fever, weakness, body pain. These have been felt by the patients, and that comes under the category of symptoms. But as compared to signs are nothing but which has been discovered by the physician. So like, say for example, if you're looking very pale, looking pale, which has been discovered by the clinician, and if you're lost weight, which has been discovered by the clinician, so that comes under the category of signs. Different terms are like diagnosis, prognosis, treatment, preventions. These are the most common terms which we usually use, but that plays a very important role in the when we study about pathology. So there are different types of subdivisions of pathology. The most important subdivisions of pathology is histopathology. Histopathology is also called as anatomic pathology or pathologic anatomy or morbid anatomy. It is basically, if you see, it is nothing but the study of a tissue. So it has been divided into three main types. One is called as surgical pathology. Surgical pathology is nothing but if you study the tissue, which has been removed by the removed from the living body by a surgical procedure. So that comes under the study of surgical pathology. So there are different types of methods, like the common method is paraffin embedding technique. We can do frozen sections by rapid diagnosis. So these are the things we can apply when you do surgical pathology. The second division of histopathology is forensic pathology or autopsy work. The same or tissue or organ you study, but then that has been taken by a dead person through the process of post-mortem for medical legal work. So that comes under the category of forensic pathology. Next is cytopathology. Cytopathology is nothing but it is the study of a cell, and the most important form of cytopathology is one is exfoliative cytology, which can be exfoliative cytology, and also FNAC, which is a fine needle aspiration cytology for a deep seated lesions for diagnosis. So exfoliative cytology, in case of exfoliative cytology, the cell which has been set up from a particular area which we can study for examination. And finally, aspiration cytology is nothing but we use a fine needle out here to aspirate a content from a tumor and study the morphology of that cell. So that is termed as FNAC. So that is the main, these are the three subdivisions of histopathology. The next is hematology. Hematology is nothing but if you study the disease in relationship with the blood, which is called as hematology. Chemical pathologies are nothing but any kind of chemical constituent you study in a urine sample or CSF sample or semen sample or any body fluid, like if you study a concentration of sugar or protein or albumin or globulin. So that comes under chemical pathology. Sometimes we used to call it as biochemical examinations also. And immunological is nothing but detections of abnormalities in the immune system. Comes under immunology or immunological pathology. Experimental pathology is nothing but in the same kind of study you will do in an experimental animal by inducing some kind of disorder. It comes under experimental pathology. Geographic pathologies are nothing but when you study a specific population in a different set of area, then it comes under geographic pathology. Medical genetics are nothing but it is a branch of human genetics that deals with the disease and its hereditary status, blood groups, inborn error of metabolism, chromosomal abnormalities, congenital malformation, neoplasm, etc. comes under medical genetics. Last but not the least, we have molecular pathology, wherein there's a diagnosis and detection of abnormalities till the level of DNA. So that is different types of subdivision or branches of pathology. If you have any questions regarding introduction of pathology, then do write in a comment box. I'll be very happy to help you. Thank you so much.